I remember watching TV, and on the news, they had a report from the Orange County Transgender Association.
On the average of around one a week, somewhere in the United States, an individual is undergoing an operation to change his or her sex. The operation has become much more prevalent than the general public has realized.
I called him up, said that I was looking for a therapist. I couldn't tell him my name or who I was. And for the first time, I could really kind of sit down and try to, with a professional, try to figure myself out.
It was hard for me to understand at first. I started taking hormone pills and had electrolysis to get rid of the beard. And, I'll never forget just having to get up out of the middle of class in sixth grade because I was just buried a breakdown in tears. And nobody knew why. And I just got up and ran out of the room. And I just went and cried in the hallway. But it wasn't because my dad was going to transition. I was afraid my father was going to transition into someone and go somewhere and I would never see my father again. Yeah, those were tough times.
I tried the transition. But I was too scared. Too scared. Five, 6 months later, I met Kris. And she was great for me to kind of pull me out of my funk and get me going, getting back into life as Bruce. I can't do the other thing, so let's just be a good Bruce.
Our kids, they're so excited about the first day of school. Here they come. And we'll go with Chloe first. Now, Chloe, I know you're so excited about your first day of school. Uniform girl, here's Kimberly. Yes.
I love being a dad. I love carpooling kids. I love giving them advice and bringing all these kids up.
The first thing we have on the calendar is the puppet show.
The issue is not going away.
Whatever happens, I always want you to know that Daddy loves you and that I think you're just a wonderful little girl and that I have a kiss.
We're still recording, okay? Now, what do we have to say? We have to say, hi, everybody. It's Christmas, 1997.
Oh, my gosh, she's going so fast. She's going so fast.
I was experimenting a lot. And I thought, maybe I can survive by just cross-dressing behind closed doors and still keep the old Bruce around.
Start of the race, we got Brandon, Brody, and all the Jenner kids here.
Brody's here?
I remember one time I was at the Marriott in Orlando, Florida. And all I had to do all day is give one-hour presentation, so I had the rest of the time to myself. And I thought, okay, I can sneak out, get in the car, just drive around. Just that little bit of freedom. Drove around for an hour and came back. And I'm walking through the lobby towards the elevator and kind of going by the bar. And this guy comes running up to me, says, I love trans women. Ran down the hall, slammed the door. My heart was pounding, and I was scared to death. And I'm thinking, that was so close to getting caught. But I learned I was very comfortable that way.
Thank you very much.
But then the show, it was an immediate change. The world was different now.